The Honourable Member for Concordia.
Mr. Speaker, giving people of any age access to more educational options will directly translate into a better trained workforce that's ready to adapt and prepare for the jobs of tomorrow and keep Manitoba growing. We want young people to encounter no wrong doors in their education, and students want to see universities and colleges work together to provide more opportunities and a more seamless post-secondary education system. Will the Minister of Education please inform the House of the new post-secondary secondary strategy announced today by the Premier that will give students more options and prepare them for rewarding careers right here in Manitoba?
The Honourable Minister of Education.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I thank my friend from Concordia for such a great question. I was pleased today to be with the Premier at Urban Circle, along with our partners in the educational system, to unveil a new post-secondary education strategy that will give our students opportunities to take online courses, access e-textbooks, and have an easier time transferring credits. Mr. Speaker, our objective with this strategy is to create a seamless post-secondary education system where there are no wrong doors, no dead ends, multiple pathways for student success leading to good jobs here in Manitoba. Now, Mr. Speaker, contrast that with the Leader of the Opposition. When he was in government, tuition skyrocketed by 132% and enrollment declined by 8%. Mr. Speaker, I've said this many times and I'm going to say it again, the greatest threat to the education system in the province of Manitoba is the Leader of the Opposition and his caucus.
The Honourable Minister's time in this question has elapsed.